Hi, I'm 7 kilometers from Sapa in this beautiful valley over here, and you can see these indigenous tribal people, how they are living in these valleys. I am here at in one of the exhibition centers, but outside as well, this kind of craft is still going on. You will see them sewing and selling hats and trinkets and things like that, even now. These are the young women and females who are constantly working on the wheels and trying to produce different designs of little things that they sell to the tourists, like hats and some sort of trinkets or cufflinks and stuff like that. There is one there, she's blowing with the fire and melting the jewelry. So this is the kind of crafts we are seeing in Sapa, actually, and it's still very rural in the sense that the kind of the people that are living here, they are using these kind of wooden instruments and wooden wooden still in like in the olden days how they used to be. So it's you can see these crafts and the people in the valleys, how they are dancing, and I've just been come from the valley, and it's exactly just the way as it is in this exhibition hall. So it's making a lot easier for me just to do the filming over here. I just want to just take you around to these are some sort of, I think, musical instruments, but I'm not very sure. This is kind of a marriage procession, I think, how they still get married till today. If you come to Sapa and if you catch a marriage ceremony, then it's really worth it's really a different experience how the people over here are celebrating their culture. Here the people are not very they're not really Buddhists as such, because it just depends on the family. But in Sapa, they managed to maintain their culture through family tradition. Also, the other thing is that a lot of French people have come here, and researchers have come here in this exhibition hall. And also, a lot of research has been done, and they have been endorsed, these French researchers. Basically, they have found a lot of stones and carvings, which are like written from many, many centuries ago. And they are still trying to decipher the writing on these stones and what they actually mean. So there's a lot of depth in Sapa's its own ways compared to the other parts of Vietnam. Like in Hanoi is somewhat much more livelier and bubblier, but here it's much more quieter. I'm just going to scroll up to this map, and please, if you can have a look. That pink line there, basically the thick pink line, is the area that is basically covering the Sapa region. This whole map is about the Sapa region, but in this map what they are showing is the different rock excavations that have gone on with various writings on them, which French researchers have discovered on several stones with figures and some 200 stones apparently, and carving stones, and the writing is in form of parallel lines or in forms of rectangular shapes and things like that. So they're still excavating and finding different carvings and excavation mark here. But here there is some a picture diagram, as you can see, and with some of the kind of inscriptions that you may find of animal figures and very primitive writings or drawings, pictorial form, which have been found. So that's where they want to maintain the culture here and also carry on with these indigenous ways and attract the foreign tourists who keep coming over here to enjoy. I'm just going to take you outside the exhibition hall so you can see the valley as well as, you know, that this is exactly how it is inside. The exhibition hall is also the outside. So I'm just standing at the top and you can see there's a mist at the moment outside on these massive, beautiful mountains. I'm in a valley here, 7 kilometers away from the main city of Sapa. And obviously it's raining, so a lot of people have gone away. That's a local shop in front of me, and there are a few children sitting and playing inside. So this is how the Sapa is. It's really very beautiful, very, very quiet, very, very peaceful. And if it's the kind of location you want to be in, then I would certainly recommend that. This place has got such a beautiful quietness, and it's really nice over here. There's a pin drop silence as well. So on that note, I'm just going to end this tape because I've managed to get everything in this tape about the culture and what is going on in this region. Right at the back there, if you can see in the tape, there is a river flowing as well, that beautiful river. And then there's rice paddies as well. And you can walk down those rice paddy fields over here, right to the bottom to the river point. And you know, it's just a very nice walk and very quiet and beautiful. There's no houses. There's a pathway as well, so you could do that. And then basically, this is the only one community hall in which happened to be the exhibition today on May 12th, 2018. Thank you very much for watching. Bye-bye.